Wakonda, known as the Great Spirit. This is a deity who is associated with creation and comes to us from the cultures of the Omaha, Osage, and Ponca tribes of North America. He is classified through my terms as a primordial god who is a creator, but through this belief system, he would be classified as a high god. They never personify deities in the way that other belief systems do. So this great creator force is an abstract, omnipresent creative force who was never personified himself. And the name has come to designate an invisible life force, which again is omnipresent and which is used by humans when they're in need of help from this very powerful but benevolent creator. I think the most noteworthy component of this is how these people saw their deities and how they represented them. We can make an easy comparison to Greek or Norse mythology, in which the forces of nature were personified in a deity who we could interact with. In the terms of Greek mythology, these were deities who we may go to war with or fight with or fall in love with and have children with. And that casts a very different barrier between our world and the supposed divine world. So again, we learn a lot by looking at various cultures, and in this case, our lesson comes from these native people who saw their deity as being outside of themselves and outside of their physical world, and truly a representation of spiritual power, omnipresence, and benevolence and love for humans and the people that it ultimately created. Thank you again for stopping at Nine World Chronicles. We'll continue with other videos looking at various types of beliefs and how those beliefs connect with one another.